Well, Tom and Shelley, Teresa Gilman says it was stressful just to be in the same room as one of the men who allegedly killed her son.
31-year-old William Edick is facing multiple charges, including second-degree murder in the death of Anthony Renzulla. The state prison inmate's arraignment comes 1 week after a former inmate, 30-year-old Thomas Milton, was arrested while on probation in Florida. Prosecutors say in a July 2010 attack behind bars, Edick and Milton beat Renzulla so severely that he never woke up and died a year later.
Both Mr. Edick and Mr. Milton attacked Mr. Renzulla by kicking him in the head repeatedly and also in the face, and that's what led to the reckless murder charge against them both.
Edick is currently serving prison time for unrelated offenses. Anthony Renzulla's mother spoke to News 9 by phone to explain what it was like to finally see someone charged in court for her son's death after waiting for nearly 3 years.
I try to get out of the sadness because I know at the end it's going to be happiness, you know, especially seeing these two guys are going to get, hopefully they're going to get what they deserve.
Gilman says her son had his troubles but did not deserve the death sentence he received from his attackers. She says the pain of losing her son has not faded.
For a while there you feel, well, you know, things are going pretty good and you're not even, you know, you're not sad anymore about Tony. But then all of a sudden something clicks and then your mind goes right, you know, to the day that the prison called me to tell me what had happened to Tony.
Thomas Milton is still in the process of being extradited to New Hampshire. William Edick will remain behind bars. Teresa Gilman says prosecutors have told her to expect trials sometime next year.
Investigators say part of the delay in making arrests in this case was due to the fact that Anthony Renzulla was heavily medicated during his time in the hospital, and extensive tests were needed to officially rule out any other possible cause of death. Reporting live in the newsroom, Adam Sexton, WMUR-TV.